Chapter 10 Circles. To a new topic now, arcs and types of arcs. So again, to know what is an arc, I need a circle. So let me consider a circle. So we can define arc as, arc is a part of a circle. To get part of a circle, I need at least two points on the circle. So let me consider two points on the circle. So suppose this is point A and this is point B. So I have two points on the circle. So this two points on the circle will divide the circle into parts. Let us see how. From A to B, I have this part over here. So I can call this as arc AB. But the problem is, if I name this as arc AB, so if I name this as arc AB, I have two options for arc AB. Arc AB can be like this over here. Arc AB, I can move like this as well. So I have two options. So arc AB, so two points are enough to make an arc. But to name an arc, I need at least three points. Let us see how. So let me fix these two points A and B. Now let me insert one more point between A and B over here. Suppose that point is point X. And let me insert one more point in between A and B on the larger part. Suppose Y. After inserting X and Y, now it is very clear. If I say you arc AXB, now it is very specific. Arc AXB will be this part that is lying down over here from A to B, and arc AYB. Now it is very clear and specific. Arc AYB will be this arc over here, the bigger arc. So to name an arc, basically we need 3 points. To make an arc, 2 points are enough. But to name an arc, we need 3 points. Arcs are basically classified into 3 types. The first type is minor arc. The second type is major arc. And your third type is semicircular arc. First of all, let us see what is a semicircular arc. Suppose if I consider two points on the circle, say A and B. So if I consider two points on the circle, point A and point B. And suppose if I say point O is the center of the circle. Let me join AB now. Now when I join AB, I know that it passes through the center of the circle. That is, AB can be called as the diameter. So since AB is the diameter, this diameter will form semicircular arc. Now the two arcs formed over here, that is this arc, from A to B can be called as the semicircular arc. Again, this arc over here from A to B can be called as the semicircular arc. So the arc formed due to the diameter of the circle is called a semicircular arc, but I am not naming this as arc AB. I need a third point over there. So again, I am taking a point on the circle. Let me name this as P. Taking one more point over here down. Let me name this as Q. So I can say arc APB. So arc APB. As well as arc AQB. Both of them can be called as semicircular arc. Now, let us move on to minor arc. So, minor arc is an arc which measures less than semicircle. So, suppose if I consider a point. Suppose if I consider a point over here. Let me name this point as a point R. Now observe this part from A to Q. Arc ARQ is less than arc AQB. AQB is the semicircle and ARQ is smaller than the semicircle. So yes, I can say that arc AQB is the minor arc because it is less than semicircular arc. You can create many more minor arcs over here. If I take a point over here, say M. Again, I can say this arc, that is PMB, again minor arc. Also APM, APM will be a minor arc. So these are all minor arcs. So arcs which measure less than semicircle are said to be minor arcs. Now let me keep the same points on the circle and let me take one of the examples of major arc. If I consider an arc from point B to point R in this direction, you can see here, I need to mark like this. Just concentrate on this blue lines. So I'm taking arc from point B till point R. From point B till point R over here. So from R to point B. In this direction, we can clearly see that APB, we know that APB was semicircle. Now this arc RAB, so RAB is bigger than the semicircle. So we can say that RAB comes in the category of major arc. So we have arc RAB. So this arc is bigger than the semicircular arc, therefore it is the major arc. So arc which is formed due to the diameter of the circle is called as a semicircular arc. Then arc which is less than the semicircular arc is a minor arc, and arc which is greater than the semicircular arc is a major arc. So in this way we have defined minor arc, major arc, semicircular arc, and arc is nothing but a part of a circle. Now let us see what is the central angle. Simple one, central angle is an angle formed at the center of the circle due to the two radii. So I need a circle, suppose this is circle, and suppose this point O is the center of the circle. So if I draw two radii over here, that is this two like this, let me name them. Say for example OA and OB. So OA and OB are the two radii of the circle. The angle formed at the center of the circle, this angle over here. So angle AOB, so angle formed at the center of the circle will be called as the central angle. So we can say this angle AOB is a central angle. If I draw one more radius like this, and if I name this point as P, again this angle over here can also be called a central angle. It will be angle AOP. So these are central angles, that is angle formed at the center of the circle. Now let us move on further, that is measure of arc. Suppose this is the circle, let me name the center of the circle, say point O. So O is the center of the circle. Let me take two points on the circle, say for example point A and point B. Let me join point A and point B with the center of the circle. So I join OA, I join OB. So I get a central angle. That central angle is angle AOB, as we already know. But can we say we have an arc over here, that is arc AB? To be more specific, let me insert one point over here. Suppose that point is point X. Now we have this arc AXB. First of all, we already know that arc is measured in degrees. So arc is measured in degrees. But we cannot keep the protractor over here and check what is the measure of this arc. So this measure of the arc depends upon the central angle. So the measure of arc generally depends upon the central angle. Say for example, I have the central angle, angle AOP is equal to say 100 degrees. Then we will say that measure of this arc AXB is also equal to 100 degrees. That is, we will say measure of arc AXB. Is equal to measure of this arc AXB is equal to 100 degree. That is measure of arc AXB is equal to measure of angle AOB. That means what we are supposed to remember is measure of the arc depends upon the central angle. I'll give you one more example. Suppose I have two segments like this. Let me name the points as P and Q. So I have this arc over here, PQ. To be more specific, I put a point over here and say I have R. And I have this central angle over here. Suppose the central angle over here is 30 degree. Measure of this arc PRQ is also equal to 30 degree. That is, measure of the central angle is equal to its measure of the corresponding arc. Or you can say measure of the arc is equal to measure of the corresponding central angle.